If we really want to understand how the human brain is organized and how the structure of the brain can give rise to all of our mental capabilities, there's no substitute for studying the human brain itself. While there are many things that you can study in dead tissue, you can study structure, study genes, for example, if you want to understand the function of cells or the function of circuits, you have to study living brain. So over the past 5 years or so, we've really worked to set up collaborations with a whole network of local surgeons. And typically, in order to access pathological regions, it's necessary to go through part of the normal brain. Those regions are typically excised and thrown away as medical waste. But it turns out that they're actually extremely healthy. We're able to take these tissues and take them into a laboratory setting. The sort of most basic piece of information that one can get from these tissues are the electrical firing properties of neurons and the shape of the neurons. And we can use these two pieces of information to really begin to understand the types of cells. There's absolutely a sense of aesthetic beauty to the neurons in the brain. And somehow, these human neurons, with their increased complexity, have the capacity to inspire even more awe about this system. So this is really the first of its kind of a very systematic approach to characterize the cells of the human and to put all of this as a freely accessible resource to everyone in the community.
One of the really exciting things about working with the Allen Institute is they think big. They don't think where are the limits, but rather how can we go beyond the limits. The impact on humanity could be extremely broad because we're just scratching the surface on the mechanisms behind who we are and the disease states that affect who we are. I very much hope that this helps treat epilepsy and helps us develop new therapies, but it could just as well help us with our understanding of aging or Alzheimer's or autism, and we don't close the door on any of those possibilities.
I think what's really amazing is that despite the scientific community wanting to understand the human brain, there's almost nothing out there publicly about the human brain at the level of its cell types. We're really releasing something very novel here. Hopefully not novel for long, but at this point, I think it's a novel contribution that will allow people to see just how different things are in the human.